Menos mal que el señor Tonucci ha traído la campana desde Roma.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm lucky that Mr. Tonucci has brought his own bell all the way from Rome. It's an honor for me to introduce Francesco Tonucci. He's a researcher at the Institute of Science and Technology for Cognition, the Italian National Research Council. He has worked in various aspects of child development with relation to school, family, and the city. He has been involved in the training of teachers for both infant school and environmental education, and he is famous for his cartoons on children. Mar Romera is joining us today. She's a teacher and she has a degree in pedagogy and psychology, and she doesn't want me to continue, actually. So you both have the floor. Thank you. What was published was the fact that this was going to be a dialogue between Mar and Frato. But the truth is that Frato doesn't really answer any questions without drawing. So our idea was to choose some of my cartoons specifically to provide answers to those questions. So we've decided to show Frato's cartoons, and Mar and Tonucci use words, put words to these cartoons. And let's see how this works. Let's see how we do. Frato has accompanied me for over 40 years with his irony and his drawings. As a prologue, Frato, like Kino's characters, were born out of the influence of psychology. It was based on the measurement test on non-verbal aggression, TEMA for its acronym in Italian and Spanish. These are some of the very initial drawings. Frato was born in 1968. This was the very first drawing. And he was born out of a need back then that we all felt, maybe a little less in Spain out of its own historical and political context. I was a researcher in education. But teachers couldn't really read my papers because they didn't really have access to those journals. And to start drawing was my way to enter the world of schools. These are some of the characters.
Y aquí empieza un recorrido que pasa por la vida de la nuestra, de las niñas y de los niños, esperando
this is
a nacer.
The journey that children undergo when they are about to be born.
Ahora ya sabemos que está sano, que pesa 4 kilos, que es niño y mide unos 65 centímetros.
Now we know that you're healthy, that the boy is already 4 kilos and 65 meters long.
Lo siento, señora, pero no puedo
it's not a surprise anymore. I'm sorry, miss, but I can't see what sex the baby is. Genetic manipulation.
La violencia del nacimiento.
The violence of birth.
Los primeros días.
The first few days.
Otra vez por aquí, doctor, que ya pasó un mes. Y entonces,
it's been a month already, doctor. So, how do you see my little boy? I feel like
revisión.
A car going to be checked for the second time.
Pues sí. Ayer empecé a usar los pañales esos que anuncian en televisión.
I started using, you know, those products that were on TV, but it looks like he hasn't even peed. I don't know. I must be really sick because I'm the only one who doesn't seem to be peeing.
Si vieras lo bien que está con el parque y con todos sus juguetes.
Oh, you would love it, seeing him at the park with all his toys.
Antes de la escuela.
Before school.
La guardería no es un perchero.
Nursery is not a hangar.
12 horas en la guardería.
12 hours at nursery.
Cambiar al niño.
35 segundos.
Changing the baby. 35 seconds. Is it worthwhile getting dirty like this? Mother's school.
Bienvenido. Ahora vamos a presentarnos para
Welcome.
Conocernos mejor.
Now we'll introduce ourselves to get to know each other better. My name is Giovanni Rossi. I'm a single child. My father is Andrea and a barber. My mom is Luisa and she works at home. I've already had measles, I spent a year at nursery, I liked it quite all right, but I didn't like rice. I watch TV and play video games. I still pee in the bed. I'd like to be the driver of rockets. Okay, darling, I'm your teacher. To get to know each other, to enjoy together.
Hola, cariño.
The meeting. Hi, honey. Good morning.
¿Ves ese reactor? Pues seguro que es supersónico.
Do you see that reactor? I'm sure it's supersonic. What are you saying? If it doesn't have delta wings.
Se acabó. Ahora tenemos que volver a enhebrar esas malditas bolitas, dichosos collares.
It's over.
El punzón. Esto para introducir una cosa muy bonita que
I use this to talk about something happening in Reggio Emilia. This instrument that scared me was used against, but for a new sense. In a creative way, asking for all the kids' parents to make a wooden box with a battery. When the box was covered with a black paper, if you switch off the lights and close the windows, the kids could take this instrument and could free some light spots, and this is what you can say, this is a light drawing.
Niños, hoy vamos a salir fuera. Vamos a visitar el barrio.
Kids, we're going out today. We're going out. Follow me, in twos. Hold your hands. Don't get distracted. Don't go into the street. And now we'll go back to the class, and you'll draw what left an impression on you.
Las salidas para conocer.
Our excursions.
Voy a hacerme mayor.
I'm going to get older.
El niño programado.
The programmed kid.
Un par de años para pasarlo en grande. Viajes, excursiones, esquí, vacaciones. Luego tuvieron que ahorrar un poco para comprar una casa y amueblarla. Después, papá tuvo un ascenso y por fin quisieron tenerme, justo poco antes de jubilarse.
Anda a jugar y disfrutar.
Come on. Go play and enjoy.
Ponte bien la bufanda, que esta noche hace frío.
It's cold tonight.
No gritéis.
Don't shout.
Es un niño con suerte. No le falta de nada.
What a lucky boy. He doesn't miss anything.
Queridos amigos, hoy os mostraremos con magníficas
imágenes. Dear friends, we'll show you the fascinating life.
Siempre delante del televisor, apágalo y haz los deberes.
Always in front of TV. Turn it off and do your housework. The green frog, the green frog, the green frog.
¿Tú crees que los domingos y en vacaciones los maestros tienen que hacer los deberes?
Do you think that teachers need to do homework on Sundays and on holiday?
No empujéis, que no tengo prisa para crecer.
Don't push me.
Crecerás, aprenderás mañana.
You'll grow, you'll see, you'll learn tomorrow.
El misterio del sexo.
The mystery of sex.
Mira, papá te va a contar cómo nacen los niños.
Look, papá is going to tell you how kids are born.
En que las abejas vuelan
Have you
flor en flor?
Seen any time how the bees fly from flower to flower? Yes. What they do is taking the pollen from the flowers and they take it to...
Mamá, ¿dónde está el hermanito?
Mom, where's my little brother?
In mom's chest.
My mom's gonna have twins.
Justamente esta fue la primera viñeta que dibujó Frato.
That was the first Frato's design in 68. This is from an original book I found after a long time. And it represents the style and the philosophy of her drawings. It's about the relationship between us and the kids. So a relationship sometimes built after lies, like the ones we use, for example, when we talk about the birth, it's not too poetic, and sometimes kids don't understand anything. But
Pero exactamente cómo se hace un niño.
Sí, cariño, papá te lo
But how do you create a kid?
Hombre,
yeah, darling. You know, the male's tail, you know, it gets bigger and bigger and it gets hard. And when it's hard, it penetrates into women's vagina. It comes in and out.
Entonces se pone anestesia, ¿verdad?
And the woman then has some anesthesia?
Mamá, ¿cómo tuviste al hermanito?
Mamá, how did we get my young brother? I went to the garden and it was under a rose. And me? Yeah, you were under a different plant. But mom, have you ever had a normal birth?
Si agarras la mermelada, te voy a cortar la colita.
¡No lo hagas!
Watch out. Don't take the marmalade.
Don't do it. Oh, she did.
Mamá, cuando sea mayor quiero hacer de papá.
Mom, I want to be like dad when I grow old.
La adolescencia.
Teenagers.
La adolescencia 2.
Teenagers 2.
El juego.
The game.
Dime lo que sea más caro. Es que sabe, no paso mucho tiempo con mi hijo.
Give me what it is more expensive, you know. I don't spend much time with my son.
Nada de eso, querido. No te puedes ir. Hoy te toca jugar.
No. I'm sorry, darling. You can't leave. You have to play with the kid. I had to do it yesterday and the day before.
Simplemente jugando.
Simply playing.
Llegas 2 horas tarde.
You're 2 hours late.
Pero es que tenía que recuperar.
I'm sorry, but I couldn't play yesterday because I had to do my homework. Article 31st. The kid has the right to play. This is a nice dry picture in Rosario, Argentina, that I would like to find in our places. It means just watch out, kids are playing in the street. And this is a different one I really like in Miraflores. It's a neighborhood in Lima, in Peru. It says it's forbidden to play ball except kids. And I really agree. We make the rules. We can tell teenagers, do not disturb. But what I think is that we have to agree that kids, boys and girls, bambino e bambina in Italian, till 10, 11 years, till that age, kids should have the right to play wherever and however they want. Because if we don't do so, we are making adults to go always with them. And we are actually, in fact, prohibiting to play. This is a modern game. 3 kids playing, I hope they're playing by themselves, in a 50-people town, people in the middle of trees. So you just have to see. Safety. They say it's the best method to follow the plugs. The nurse. The hard work of the student. Primary school at 5 years. There has been quite a debate in Italy because there were some proposals about having primary school starting earlier. You know, in Finland, primary works a lot, works quite well. And there, primary school starts at 7. This is a complex drawing from the 70s. And every time I look at it, I realize that, unfortunately, it's still current, with some details, with some differences, but it is mainly the same. The school is a machine that tries to make kids the same way and that discard all the kids that are different from the rest. The desk. This was 68's desk. How you see the hierarchy from the well-dressed student till the other one. I did it again, 40 years later. Something changed, as you can see.
The experiment. We place water in front on top of the radiator. What happened if we don't have any more water? It's been evaporated. It's hidden. Well, it was just a joke.
Todo el mundo lo está mirando como raro y él se justifica.
Everybody's looking at him and he has to justify for being right.
El sol es el que gira alrededor de la Tierra.
What do you think? The sun goes around the Earth or the Earth goes around the sun?
Es el sol lo que gira.
The sun goes around the Earth.
But what have they told you in at school?
That sun stays and the Earth goes around. What did you want to know? Well, they told me what I think.
Informática en la escuela.
IT at school.
Con el profesor de lengua debo mostrarme interesado.
With literacy teacher, I have to look interested and critic. With the maths one, humble. With English, funny. With the science teacher, active entrepreneur. With arts, sad. It is so hard to have all the teachers happy.
Cuando hablamos, siempre utilizamos tres.
When we talk, we always use three key elements that I've explained throughout this month: subject, predicate, and complement. Now, let's see any face.
I read a book.
Paul plays.
The dog bites the bone.
Margarita
Samarillas! Esto un poco para entrar en el tema de las disciplinas literarias.
This is just to talk about the literary disciplines. This is an old school where kids just had to write nonsense things, senseless things, and they have to fill pages with words. That's the kind of school I went to 60 years ago. This is Martino. And this is a kid of my family. Now it's complicated to explain because now families now are quite complex. So it's not exactly my daughter's son, but her mate. Well, okay. Martino, this is 4 years ago. He is filling a page with T-T-O-T-U. And we are in the 2000s. This is Nina. She is my granddaughter. She is Martino's sister. And this is last year's notebook. And it's just bigger as the one I had. Now they're used these books where there is a space for many more words. It seems impossible because you say, okay, that's weird. And you have to really look for a exception. So in my house, twice in 4 years, this is what I saw. So this is another strange case in Italy. And this is Nina's notebook. There's another possibility of working with languages. This is Reggio Emilia again. These are proposals, the kindergarten, that make the kids sending love letters to each other. In the classroom, they got a mailbox where they can send letters. Some of them cannot write, most of them don't do it right, some of them do it more, and some other less. Luca, for example, he cannot write. So, write says, and Carla writes. This is like in the war, there are some soldiers who couldn't write and some others who wrote them. And it says, Dear Agnese, Dear Agnese, not Carla, Carla is just an instrument. Dear Agnese, I'm too much in love with you. But sometimes that makes me angry because you play with others. And I don't want that. Because who do I play with then? I can never be without you. I will get married with you tomorrow. And I also scare you. Kisses, Luca. Written by Carla. Agnese can write. This is full of mistakes, so I reading and translating correctly. And she says, Dear Luca, I cannot marry you that day. Like that you told me, because I'm too young. And I'm never going to marry because I don't like it. I play with you. Yes, but don't bother me with so many kisses. Because there are too many. I would like a bit less, please. Someday you will come my home. Please answer me with some other messages, and I will do it too. I think I found this is like a miracle. With this proposal, these kids went through writing. Answer me, and I will do it too. They see, they realize how worthwhile is writing. And sometimes it's really hard for teachers. School is open for everyone.
Luis es demasiado vivaracho.
Luis is too lively. Ana is untidy. Pedro is dull. José has skills problems. Luisa is too shy. Mercedes is not well behaved. Only Juan is normal. Signed, the teacher.
Lamentablemente, muchas veces.
Unfortunately, this is what sometimes happens.
Dear children, school is over, and until September, we won't see each other again.
Un día de los pupitres.
One day, this will blow. Desk will bloom.
Hoy os explicaré el árbol desde abajo hasta arriba. Las raíces, el tronco.
Today I'll explain the tree from top to bottom.
School of Nature.
Experimento científico 2.
This is scientific experiment 2. Today we'll do a really interesting experiment. Here we have a liquid with no color. If we mix it with the other liquid, then it will turn black. Amazing. Works. Yeah, look at this.
Maestros en formación.
Training teachers.
Hoy empezaremos con las clases de educación.
Today we'll start environment and health classes.
Qué mala suerte. Si
pudiera tener toda esta. Oh, what about luck? If I could have all this snow and ice in May, when I have to talk about Eskimos.
Si
Sentado en silencio, tranquilos y atentos.
Sit down, shut up, and pay attention.
No entiendo por qué dentro de unas horas.
I don't understand why in a few hours these children will be so nervous.
Evolución del aprendizaje diario.
Evolution of the diary learning in class. What do you do at from 10:30 to 11?
Es la hora del recreo.
It's free time.
Nuevos programas escolares.
New learning programs.
Es muy triste. Estimados maestros.
Dear teachers. Now you have to help me. With the new programs.
No, espera.
Oh, wait.
Estimados maestros, con estos nuevos programas.
Dear teacher, with these curriculums, this era finished the desks, linen, and this kind of classes. Repeat all with me. It finishes, this era finishes.
El niño ciudadano.
The citizen kid. We gotta trust everyone.
Peligro, niños.
Danger, children. It's an interesting one. Because he doesn't tell kids that they're danger. He tells drivers that they're a danger, and that danger are kids. I think this would be better a different way. Danger, cars.
Si papá me quisiera tanto como quiera su coche.
I would be so happy if dad loved me as much as he loves his car.
These are in Italian. And so you can see the translation.
Bicycles are more democratic than cars. They cost less, children can use it, you don't need a driving license, it doesn't contaminate, it doesn't take up too much space, and it helps you to exercise. A girl from the Children's Council of Granollers. Pablo, have you seen the rest of my bicycle?
Siempre perdiendo el tiempo con esa bicicleta.
Always wasting your time with that bicycle.
Señor arquitecto, en lugar de toboganes.
Dear architect, instead of loops and that playgrounds, what we want is sand, water, bush and stones.
Los niños proyectan la ciudad.
Kids drawing the city.
No deben ser demasiado seguras.
Squares don't need to be too safe. That's what Javier said this morning. This is a drawable ideas, Javier idea.
Finally, a safe square.
And a bored one.
Nos dimos cuenta que las plazas y los parques están muy aburridos desde que lo renovaron.
We realize that the squares and the parks are really bored since we renew them.
Pero a nosotros nos gustaba así.
We will change it to adapt it to children.
But we like it that way. Dear Major, we don't want loops. We want the city. Oh, they're listening to us. The kids participate. This is a children council in Rome working in commissions. This is in Rosario, Argentina. Is a meeting with the children.
Vamos solos a la escuela.
We go to school by ourselves.
No, mom, nothing has happened in the last 10 minutes.
This is about cell phones. Mobile phones, it's apparently a tool. But I always tell the students, watch out. Parents said, okay, I give to you, I chop it up, but you never have to switch it off. In case that I want to talk to you, I just have to call you. So you can tell me who are you with and where are you. So students are forced to lie, because when they are away from home, they cannot tell where are you exactly, or who are you with, or doing what.
Os cuento un secreto. Él no tiene móvil.
This is a secret. He doesn't have a mobile, but this is no revenge.
¿Cuál es la receta, doctor?
A la escuela.
What's the recipe, doctor? To school, on foot, with children, every day.
Autonomy is health. Sorry for the inconvenience. We're playing for you.
Y ahora hay algunos detalles finales.
There are some final details. This is a book I really like to draw. I do it on purpose. While the previous ones were just collections of drawings, different drawings published in magazines, but this book was draw in one. And it's for my granddaughter and grandson, Nina E. Federico. Oh, he's 26 now. And this is the last one. We made it with Amparo Tomé. She's a University of Barcelona teacher. She's a feminist. And we made this game. She wrote the text, and I made the cartoons.
Frato has had to study and reflect over 30 years to write a book about girls after that one about boys.
Para mí que estos símbolos se lo han inventado los hombres.
I think these symbols were invented by men, because we have a cross on top and theirs is hard.
Yo soy más rápida que los chicos, pero voy.
I'm quicker than boys, but I go slowly because otherwise they don't let me play.
Además de extranjera, pequeña, pobre y negra, soy chica.
I'm a foreigner and small and poor and black, but besides that, I'm a girl.
Un signore maturo con un orecchio acerbo. Poesia di Gianni Rodari. Un giorno sul diretto Capranica Viterbo vidi salire un uomo con un orecchio acerbo. Non era tanto giovane, anzi, era maturato tutto, tranne l'orecchio che acerbo era restato. Cambiai subito posto per essergli vicino e poter osservare il fenomeno per benino. Signore, gli dissi dunque, lei ha una certa età. Di quell'orecchio verde, che cosa se ne fa? Rispose gentilmente, dica pure che son vecchio, di giovane m'è rimasto soltanto questo orecchio. È un orecchio bambino, mi serve per capire le cose che i grandi non stanno mai a sentire. Ascolto quel che dicono gli alberi, gli uccelli, le nuvole che passano, i sassi, i ruscelli. Capisco anche i bambini, quando dicono cose che a un orecchio maturo sembrano misteriose. Così disse il Signore con un orecchio acerbo quel giorno sul diretto Capranica Viterbo. Un signor maduro con un'orecchia verde. Un día en el Espresso.
Soria Monterde.
Vi subir un hombre con un'orecchia verde.
The Expresso Sonia Monterde. I saw a man walking into the Expresso with a green ear. He was not young anymore. He looked old, but the ear that was still green. I seated beside him just to see what was this. And I told him, Mister, you're old, but this green eye, is it useful for you? He asked me, I'm an old man, but as young, as I only have this ear, it's a kid's one that I use to hear the things that adults never feel. I listen to the trees, the birds singing, stones, rivers, and clouds. I also hear when the kids can tell stories, the kind of things the mature ear think are mysterious. That's how the man of the green eye talked that day in El Expreso Sonia Monterde. Thank you.
Muchas gracias. Sé que muchos de los que estáis aquí habéis estado esta mañana.
Thank you. I know that most of you or many of you were in the conference this morning and you wanted to make comments and questions. We now have 20 minutes for a Q&A session. Is there any English speaker listening? If that's the case, please put up your hand so that we know whether we can continue interpreting. The question was off the mic, I'm sorry.
Parece que sea una tendencia que está cambiando en los últimos años. No sé citar la fuente. Pero lo recibí más que una vez, me encontré con estos datos.
¿Alguna otra pregunta? Bueno, estamos un poco tímidos, me parece.
No, podemos aprovechar también para recuperar los temas de esta mañana, si queréis, que un poco vuelven.
Is there any English speaker in the room listening to interpreting into English? Please put up your hand so we know whether we can continue talking. We cannot see anyone listening to interpreting into English on channel 2. So please put up your hand and let us know if that's the case, and then we'll continue.
No se llaman como en otras ocasiones o en otras colecciones o con otros autores, no tienen nombre. Y no tienen nombre porque la intención de Frato es que podamos ver a todos nuestros niños, a todas nuestras niñas, y seamos los adultos que tenemos la calma y la paciencia de leerlos, los que le pongamos nombre a esas viñetas. Otra curiosidad interesante es que la mayor parte de sus dibujos no están cerrados. Él no termina los dibujos. Algunas veces los niños...
Ahorro mucha tinta.
Le preguntan por qué y él contesta que ahorra tinta, que... No. A mí un día me lo dijo. No quiere cerrar ningún dibujo para que ningún maestro y ninguna maestra se le ocurra hacer copias para mandar a que lo pinten. Eso es una gran idea. Pero no lo cuenta todo. Él hizo un libro con ojos de niño hace mucho tiempo y con ojos de niño Frato 40 años. Y evidentemente ahora queremos dar visibilidad a las niñas y Francesco hace con ojos de niña. Pero os cuento otro secreto. Hay personajes a los que se les ve la oreja. Esos son chicos. A todos los que no se les ve la oreja son chicas. Es una muy buena manera. No es ni la ropa, ni la forma, ni el rasgo cultural que ponga en su dibujo, sino que consiste en si no se te ve la oreja, chica, si se te ve la oreja, chico. Estos son secretos que solamente se cuentan en momentos de intimidad y que os invitamos a que podáis seguir preguntando.
Yo quiero saber más secretos. Estamos en familia.
¿Qué siente Frato de ver que realmente todo lo que usted dibuja, ha escrito, todo lo que nos hace ver, nos produce mucha gracia. Nos reímos, nos parece que son realidades que ocurren, pero después, cuando volvemos a trabajar, volvemos a reiterar los mismos errores y no somos capaces de cambiar definitivamente lo que estructuralmente usted está denunciando.
Usted está citando una de las últimas viñetas que dibujé, regalándola el año pasado en Argentina, antes de irme, que era dos niños que hablan entre ellos. Uno dice, a los maestros les gusta mucho Frato. Y el otro dice, pero se olvidan de lo que dice. Y bueno, yo creo que se pueden hacer varias... Es una pregunta que puede necesitar una respuesta muy articulada y muy compleja. Por un lado, yo soy... Normalmente no soy orgulloso mucho, porque pienso siempre de haber tenido mucha suerte en la vida y haber contado cosas que no deberían maravillar mucho, porque son las cosas que cada uno de nosotros debería sentir, del sentido común. Y si a la gente le parecen cosas raras, esto me preocupa mucho, ¿no? Porque se ve que se ha perdido el sentido común. Pero una cosa que me parece importante es haber podido entrar en el mundo de la escuela con la ironía. El mundo de la escuela no es un mundo fácil, como todos los mundos poderosos, como el ejército, como la iglesia, la escuela, bueno, que soportan con dificultad la sátira, la ironía, los dibujos y tal. Y Frato ha tenido esta ventaja de entrar produciendo efectos, que son efectos muy raros y muy distintos. Hay gente que se enoja mucho, se ofende y dice, ¿cómo se permite este señor que no enseña a juzgar a la escuela de esta manera? Y otra gente se conmueve, se reconoce. Normalmente se reconocen los que menos lo merecen, los buenos. Y creo que estas dos reacciones pueden ser muy útiles para empezar un recorrido. Claro, el dibujo no tiene capacidad de acompañar, pero sí que puede tener fuerza. Puedo contarle una anécdota interesante. Yo nunca he tenido una censura sobre mis artículos, sobre mis libros escritos, pero sí que he tenido censuras en los dibujos. Se ve que los dibujos tocan aspectos delicados, sensibles, más sensibles de los textos. He tenido censuras en Italia, en España, editoriales que se negaron de publicar una u otra viñeta. No son muchas, son dos o tres, no están aquí en este montaje. Pero, bueno, yo creo que cuando una persona, una editorial publica un autor, tiene que respetar su punto de vista, no es responsable de lo que el autor escribe, no es responsable de lo que el autor dibuja, pero esto me ocurrió, repito, solo con los dibujos. Significa que los dibujos tienen una fuerza que a lo mejor la misma escritura no tiene. Y claro, que esto, el efecto que tanto los dibujos que los textos o las conferencias suscitan, siempre me produce un sentido de responsabilidad muy fuerte. Repito, que supera mis previsiones anteriores, ahora ya lo sé, y bueno, estoy resignado al hecho que me paren, que me piden, que me fotos y todo. Pero sigo considerándolo una cosa rara, y repito, esto me carga de responsabilidad, y bueno, intento a corresponder a tanto afecto y a tanta adhesión con el máximo de lo que puedo, que con la edad va disminuyendo, pero bueno, espero que de seguir.
Como se dice acá, no sé si más que
Sí, sí, ahora.
Gracias. Yo más que una pregunta, me apetecía compartir contigo especialmente una anécdota o una parte de mi vida en la que formas parte. Estábamos trabajando una serie de personas en un colegio, intentando hacer una educación diferente y haciendo cosas distintas. Por políticas, economía, cambiaron de dueños y nos obligaron a volver a retroceder a cosas que no nos gustaban. Y entonces nuestra forma de protestar fue poner un montón de viñetas tuyas en los paneles o los corchos que estaban repartidos por todo el colegio. Y bueno, al final nos acabaron echando a ese grupo de profesores. Pero... ese es el poder de los dibujos y de las viñetas que decías antes, ¿no? Pero acaba bien la historia y es que ese grupo de personas formamos un nuevo colegio en el que estamos haciendo las cosas que nos gustan. O sea, que bueno.
Otra cosa que siempre me sorprendió es que me contaron muchas personas que sus hijos pequeños, niños que no leían, pasaban mucho tiempo con mis libros de dibujos. Y a mí me sorprendió mucho porque son dibujos, como decía, que son un poco raros, no se parecen nada a los dibujos que hoy las editoriales para niños preparan con muchísimos colores, bien perfectos en los detalles, muy ricos de detalles. Yo creo que bueno, esto a mí me ha siempre emocionado mucho, porque se ve que los niños pasando estos dibujos, que repito, para ellos no deberían significar mucho, se ve que se reconocen, sienten algo que está de su parte, ¿eh? Una complicidad. Y una anécdota que conté en la introducción de un libro que aquí se conoce poco, pero si hay argentinos a lo mejor lo conocen, que es Con ojos de maestro, por lo cual casi todos los ojos lo utilicé. Este libro está dedicado a una niña de Salta, en el norte del país, de 8 años, que su hermana, maestra, me contó que cuando tenía, no sé si 5 o 6 años, le pidió de ver el libro Con ojos de niño que ella tenía porque en magisterio lo utilizaban como libro de estudio. Y esto también a mí me impactó mucho, ¿no? Que estos libros de dibujos aquí en España, en Argentina, en varios países, se han utilizado como libros, no digo de texto, pero libros aconsejados por los profesores en la universidad. Esto, por ejemplo, en Italia no ocurre nunca. Dibujos en la universidad. Y esta Paula pide a su hermana de verlo y su hermana le dice que no puede porque lo gasta, lo ruina, es un libro que ella quiere. Cuando la hermana se iba, Paula, a escondida, iba a buscar este libro y se lo miraba. Y le gustó tanto que fue al librero cerca de su casa a pedir si había otros libros de este señor. Y cuando le dijo que sí, ella empezó a ahorrar dinero de la merienda y compró todos mis libros que estaban en este tiempo. Y cuando empezó la escuela primaria, empezó a darle la paliza a su maestra diciendo, mira, que Tonucci dice que no sé qué. Por lo cual yo la asumí como mi representante oficial y le dediqué este libro. Y le dediqué este libro en una ocasión que se queda en mi experiencia y mi historia personal como una cosa rarísima, que mucho más de lo que comentabas del efecto que suscitan las viñetas o los textos. Porque en Salta me ocurrió esta experiencia inolvidable porque di 3 conferencias, un viernes por la mañana, viernes por la tarde y el sábado por la mañana, frente a más que 13.000 maestros. Aquí parece impresionante que estábamos más que 2.000 personas, no aquí, pero en el 2.000, más que 13.000 personas en un polideportivo y con el señor dueño de este polideportivo que me llamó uno de estos días, dice, pero usted tiene que explicarme cómo es posible que yo no consigo llenar este lugar con rock o baloncesto y usted, hablando de escuela, lo llena. Estas son cosas incomprensibles, porque yo, hasta ahora nadie se ha explicado cómo ha sido posible una cosa así. Y Paula era presente, y por lo cual fue una reina del primer día. Ya estamos, ¿eh?
Pues agradecer a todos y agradecer a Frato.